In Azure SQL Database, you might have reasons to export a backpack file, and you might want to do it with Azure Automation. Learn all about it this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Mike Batt, a customer engineer working on Azure SQL Database, among other things in the cloud. Mike, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you kick us off by telling us a little bit about what you do?
Sure. Thank you, Anna. Hi, everyone. I'm Mike Batt, Senior Customer Engineer here in the Northeast CSU, working with our customers supporting their digital transformation with everything SQL related as well as on-prem and Azure.
Awesome. Okay. So you have actually quite a large scope of things you look at.
Yes.
And I should also mention that this is part of the SQL Insiders series. So really excited about this series, getting to work with folks like you and learn about things that are going on with customers. And one of the things we were going to talk about today is exporting backpack files with Azure SQL Database. And I'd love, before we get into the nitty gritty and the demo of it, what's the scenario that customers have and why do they need this?
So, for example, it's great that Microsoft does Azure SQL Database backups for our customers so they don't have to handle all that stuff. However, from time to time, customers have a need to archive it locally or archive it in Azure Storage for later bringing it back to on-prem, perhaps to do some testing or deploy other things and then import it back into the cloud. So, of course, we have automated backup, but they want to do it ad hoc from time to time. So we do have the capability to generate a backpack, and then we'll export it out to the Azure Blob Storage using Azure Automation.
Okay, got it. And I think we could do this like manually go on, you like export backpack
right.
file. But what you're going to show us is how you can kind of automate it, maybe on a schedule, maybe do some other cool stuff. Like, I'd love to see and hear how this works.
Sure, absolutely. So I do have a demo here, so let's get to it.
Awesome.
All right, so the first thing we need to do is create an Azure Automation account, which I already created here on my portal here. It's called MBA Insiders Demo, which is my Azure Automation account. I have already created a couple of Azure SQL databases as well. So once you create your automation account, next step is to create import a runbook. So we get a runbook, and then here we can click import. And you can import it from a gallery. So from the gallery, within the gallery, we have lots of useful runbooks, which are actually written by Microsoft colleagues, as well as people within the community. And once you import it, you'll publish it. So I have already taken care of that as well for us. So if you go to the gallery and browse, it will come up with lots of good information and lots of good stuff. So let's take a look. So as you can see, if I browse, there is actually a runbook for Backpack Azure SQL Database to Blob Storage.
Nice.
So you click on it, right? You select it, and then you click import. And once you import it, you'll have to provide the name and everything, which I already taken care of. So I'm going to go back and then show you where it is. So let's go back to the runbook. So I'm going to go back to the runbook. So here's my runbook. As you see, it says published, which means I already have it, it's ready to go. So once you have a runbook, next step for us is actually to link it to a schedule, but I'm gonna show you something about runbooks as well. So if you go to the edit pane, it will actually bring up the runbook for you. And then best good thing about this is if you click on a test pane, it will actually come up with all the parameters you need to pass to back up your, generate your backpack. So you pretty much specify your resource group here, database server name, admin name, passwords, as well as your storage information, for example, the account name, the endpoint for your blob storage, storage key, the container name. And the good thing about this runbook is it has something called retention days. So you can actually even specify it for a number of days. You're gonna retain it in your blob storage and it will purge if you don't wanna keep it for more than a certain number of days, which is kind of cool that we don't have to go and maintain your blobs either, right? And once that's done, and if you click on start, it will actually run it for you. And if you have any problems, it will report it. So for example, in my case, I was actually missing a couple of PowerShell modules. So it actually brought to my attention that, hey, you don't have a module here. you're not going to be able to run, you know, run the runbook. So, well, pardon the pun, run the runbook, but you're not going to be able to go ahead and set it up to generate your backpack file. So I'm going to go back, right? And then we're going to go back to the runbook. So if you're missing modules, you have to go to your automation account. And then just, there's actually a place to click for modules, which is right under runbooks, actually. Right here. And then you can actually import modules from gallery as well. So these are all modules that are available. And if you specify a specific module you're missing, you can download it from there and import it into your account. So once we have the runbooks set, we can schedule it. So I'm going to go back to the runbook. Here's my runbook. So it's in edit right now because we clicked on it to take a look. So I'm going to go back to the edit and then just say revert to publish because I already published it. Mm-hmm. So we're going to go back. And then once you have it, you click on link to schedule. And here I have schedule. As you can see, I've created one already, which is set to run today at 1:52 p.m. for a database backup, backpack generation. So I'm going to go back again. And then, yeah, of course, you have to specify all the parameters as well. But the good thing about this is actually within the account for your automation, you can specify them as variables here as well. So you can add them here as well, or you can specify it from the menu that we had, depending on how you create a runbook. As I mentioned earlier, you can have your own runbook as well. So you don't have to use the one from Gallery, but you can create one as well. So once that's done, it's pretty much you schedule it and let it run. So it actually runs a PowerShell in the background to generate your backpack. So we can actually take a look at job status once it's done. So as you can see, I have three failed, which I failed on purpose just to make sure that it reports both. If I go to completed, it will give us a status of pretty much everything that was done, right? And then there are other places you can also check. So I'm going to go back to my container and show you that I do actually have a backup of a database, backpack of a database rather. So let's go back to my storage account. So here's my storage container, Blob Service. If I click on container called DB Exports, here are all my backpacks that I generated. And once they're here, you can actually bring them on-prem using maybe Storage Explorer, or you can actually import them back into SQL Server using Management Studio.
So that this is really cool. I didn't know you could do all this using Azure Automation.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. And the best thing about this is actually you can just schedule it. So for example, if you're gonna have a major deployment or something, you can schedule it ahead of time, let it get done, and then, you know, and best thing is automation gives you a lot of options. You can actually even create alerts and things like that as well. So it's pretty neat. And there are a bunch of other places you can actually check Agile as well. So if I go to my Logical SQL Server, and then if I click on import export history, here you go. These are all the imports or exports you have created for your databases.
Gotcha. That's pretty cool. Yeah. So you can not only track in Azure Automation, but you also have a central place to track within the database server itself. Very
absolutely. Absolutely. And you can actually check these activities on the database blade itself. So if you go to the database itself and look at activity log, it will tell you when it generated the backpacks for you.
Got it. That's pretty cool that Azure Automation, even though it's just running PowerShell, is able to kind of communicate with other bits and pieces of managing in the portal.
Yep. Absolutely.
You know, when it comes to using Azure Automation, like this is a great example. Are there other examples or use cases you've seen with customers doing this, whether it's for databases or something else?
Sure, absolutely. So best one that comes to mind, and it's pretty handy. For example, if you want to maintain your indexes or update statistics, you can schedule your jobs from here. Since there's no SQL Server agent in Azure SQL Database, you can do it through here. The other good use is, let's say, for example, if you have a lot of VMs, and you want to start them or shut them down at a specific time, you can use that as well. The other useful part of it is, for example, if you need to scale up your tier for your databases, you can scale up or down using a runbook as well. And we do have a runbook for that too. So there are lots and lots of good use for automation actually.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah, that makes sense. And it seems like, you know, you mentioned a couple really great, you know, platform as a service example, but it sounded like you can also use this for VMs, I'm assuming you can use this for other other services as well. When it comes to, if we kind of come back to exporting and importing using the backpacks for Azure SQL Database, do you have any like tips or tricks as people like get into this for their workflows?
Sure. So the things to remember is there's a limit with respect to the blob storage. It's 200 gig and it's for standard storage only. No, not premium is not supported yet. So, and the other thing is make sure there are not a lot of writes happening when you're generating your backpack. That will speed it up. And last but not least, make sure your database as well as your storage account are in the same region. That will also speed it up as well. And if you need to scale up just to generate it, you can scale up, scale it back down once your backpack is generated.
Oh, okay, interesting. So you could scale up so that the backpack export takes less time.
Exactly.
And then when you're done, maybe you could even build that into the runbook that
yes.
It scales up.
Yeah, awesome. We've got a runbook as well, so you can definitely piggyback on top of that too, yeah.
Awesome, cool. Well, Mike, thanks so much for coming on the show. This has been really useful. I personally learned a lot. I think our viewers probably did as well. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like. Check the description for links to learn more about exporting backpack files in Azure SQL Database and using Azure Automation. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.